Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. For his mercies endure forever. Hallelujah. We're going to read our scripture for this morning. Would you get your Bibles with me? We're looking at Ephesians chapter 4. We're going to read verses 7. And then we'll hop back to Ephesians 2. And read verses 8 through 9. Ephesians chapter 4. Would you stand with me for the reading of God's holy word? And verse 7. And it reads, "But to each one of us, grace was given according to the measure of Christ's gift." Now would you turn with me to Ephesians 2. Amen. And we're reading from verses 8 to verses 9. And it reads, "For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast." Amen. And the scripture of the Lord is blessed. Amen. Glory to God. We thank the Lord. Amen. One more time. Amen. For being in his presence. Amen. For letting him be in this house. Amen. The blessings of the Lord is in this house. Amen. Glory to God. And we thank him. Amen. Glory to God. We give him glory. I allow God to have his way, and I give the sky.
unity, faith, and holiness, and faith and holiness outreach and deliverance ministry international.
Hallelujah.
We are happy to have you here celebrating with us 5 years.
Amen.
On our church anniversary under the theme of people graced by God. Please do allow the Holy Spirit to have his way. Jump, shout, clap your hands, and feel free to get loose in here.
Amen.
So we welcome you, we welcome you, we welcome you. And be blessed.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Amen. Make you feel a little better. Amen. Does our visitors feel a little bit better? Can I hear you in the house?
Yes.
Listen now, we just want you to. We are one in the kingdom of God. Amen. Glory to God. I don't know about you, but I'm your sister. Amen. Glory to God. And God has the church. Amen. I'm celebrating my birthday. Amen. Glory to the God.
I would just like to thank everyone who took part in the services.
To the members of this house, thank you for everything that you've done, whether it's something big or small. I appreciate it. I appreciate it and you. I pray that as a family, we continue to grow spiritually in the Lord, for this is the season of redemption and faith. For we are seeds of the Lord, and the plans that God has for us is greater than the plans we have for ourselves. As we start this new chapter in our lives and for the house, let us continue to push and wear the full armor of the Lord, for we are truly graced by God. To our visitors, thank you for your support. You are truly appreciated as well. I encourage you to stay strong, to stay positive, and to keep fighting for greatness. For Proverbs 14:23 says, in all labor there is profit. So I conclude this message with a reminder, remember we must be ready for the Lord's coming without spot or wrinkle. And yes, Jesus is coming and we must be ready when he comes.
Amen.
Our church history. In August 2013, the Lord spoke to Pastor Faith Pasenny while sitting in our office at Social Services. God said, I've called you to do my work. And the exact moment he gave Pastor Faith Pasenny the name Faith and Holiness Outreach and Deliverance Ministries International. Faith, he said, always have faith in me. Holiness, to always remember that holiness without which no man shall see the Lord. Deliverance, he said, deliverance must come to the hurting and the brokenhearted. Outreach, part of the assignment is to go out. He said, the harvest is ripe, but the laborers are few. Ministry, because this is a ministry. International, the ministry will be known internationally. It then became a battle with the Lord. Faith, Pastor Faith then said, Lord, the church has the word faith in it, and faith is my name. People will think that I name the church after me. The Lord then answered and said, Faith was here before faith. Pastor Faith was here. Faith was here before faith. Pastor Faith was here. Which then became understandable. From the month of September to December 2013, Pastor Faith worked on developing the ministry. The ministry's logo, a motto, vision, email, website, everything was put in place. In January 2014, the Lord allowed the ministry to be birthed through Push Revival. He said, there are people that are set aside to do my work. There are people sitting on their gifts that I have blessed them with. They need to be recognized, and recognize what's on the inside of them. They need a push. Ever since then, whenever the Lord led the ministry, part of this assignment was outreach. The ministry then started giving out clothing, food, hosting street service, counseling the broken, and reaching the lost. At this time, the ministry was not in the four walls of a building as yet. In December 2015, the Lord said, it's time to start looking for a building. Pastor Faith obeyed the particular task. There were numerous buildings seen, but the approval of the Lord was not heard. 2016 came, and a building was still not found. Then the Lord had an apostle while in conversation with Pastor Faith, stating, why don't you have a fundraiser and I'll assist you? The ministry was in need financially. During this time, a sister in Christ came to Pastor Faith and asked, are you still looking for a building? Pastor Faith said, yes. She took Pastor Pasenny to a building site as Pastor Pasenny spoke and said, this is the one. Pastor Faith then said, Lord, really? He said, yes, you are on an assignment. I did not send you here for the building, but I sent you here for the people. The building needed to be repaired. The ministry needed chairs, speakers, microphones, and much more. Despite all of this, on the 24th, the ministry held its first service with no chairs, no music, just God, a few persons in the very building. However, ever since then, God has worked miracles for the ministry. He has opened doors and brought in faithful members. God has set the foundation for the ministry. The Bible says, except the Lord builds, the house that labor in vain.
Praise God, praise God. Hallelujah.
Our projects for 2019. To start a monthly outreach and evangelism team, implement an intercessory team, put in place a 24-hour prayer and counseling hotline. Start to save our youth program in the schools, starting a work network with charitable groups, acquire a church bus, start the outreach pantry. Thank you for your attention.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. Just mind the fact the Lord is with you. Amen. Glory to God. I give God thanks. Amen. For what He is doing. Amen. In the house. Amen. What He's doing amongst us. I would dare not tell you that it's an easy road. It is not an easy road. But I am committed to God.
Amen.
I'm committed to Him. How am I committed to Him? When you are in a relationship with someone, you'll do anything they ask you to do.
Yeah.
Because you just love them so much. Well, I'm in love with Jesus.
Amen.
And because I'm in love with Him, whatever He tells me to do, wherever He tells me to go, whatever passion it is, I do what He said. And so, I want to entreat with you, if you are not in love, I'm not talking about coming to church. I'm talking about singing on a praise team and maybe going to prayer. I mean, I'm talking about a relationship, being in love. Listen, okay, y'all don't understand what I talk about here. I just get chill bumps. I don't know that like puppy love, amen, we might have to amen somebody, but I got a love for Jesus.
Oh, yeah.
Listen, let me tell you something. That love has helped me walk in this. Listen, for almost 2 weeks now, off and on, I got no ride. You're calling around trying to get by the church. I start saying, man, I start walking in church.
Jesus.
I start walking in church. And guess what? It wasn't church time. I just needed to come by the church.
Yeah.
Because why? I'm in love with Him. I just want to do what He says. Man, listen, you gotta understand how this thing is. Maybe y'all ain't know, but I pray that y'all get there. I just want to sing a piece of the song. I ain't practiced this or nothing like that, but falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus. Oh, falling in love with Jesus. The best thing I've ever done is a God. I'm just saying, I'm going to be a good man.